Hello friends, today we are going to study about the topic of class 10th, Real Numbers, chapter 1. Second topic, that is your Euclid's division lemma, as we have first discussed about number system, that is the first topic. So before that, I am going to just discuss quickly about division. What is division? Like, I have taken two boxes A and B and I have taken 5 candies. So I have to divide these candies in two boxes equally. So how are we going to divide? We'll put one candy in A box, second candy in B box, third candy is A, fourth in B, and the last one is left out because it is alone. No pair is there, right? So we can't divide the single candy in two boxes equally, right? So therefore, we can say that each box will contain two candies and one is left out. So how we are going to write it numerically? Numerically, it can be written as 5 candies are divided by 2 boxes in 2 boxes. So each box will contain 2 candies and your 1 will be the remainder, right? Similarly, if I take 6 candies, so 6 candies can be equally divided between 2 boxes and each box will contain 3 candies, right? And your remainder will come out to be 0. That means no candy is left out. It can be written mathematically as dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder, as we have done this earlier. So dividend here is your 5 in the first example, and that is equal to 2, that is divisor, into quotient 2 plus the remainder 1, right? And the second equation is 6 is equal to 2 into 3 plus 0. So these two equations can be written like this. So, in general, if we take any number A and B, two numbers, two integers A and B, so your dividend will be A, divisor will be B. Then, if you divide your numbers A by B, you will get a quotient, some quotient you will get, that may be Q. And if you divide it by some number, say C, so you will get a remainder R. Right, so this can be written as A is equal to BQ plus R, and that is what Euclid's lemma says. It says that given positive integers A and B, there exist unique integers say Q and R satisfying A is equal to BQ plus R, where R lies between 0 and B. This is the condition which says that your R, your remainder, will always be less than your divisor. Obviously, if it is equal to divisor, that means agar divisor 2 hai aur remainder bhi 2 ho jaye, to obviously isko divide kar dega, to ye remainder to bachega nahi. And agar suppose kar lo ye bada hoga, to bhi ye ise divide karega. Then the remainder will be 1 again. So therefore, remainder hamesha jo divisor hai usse chota hi hoga. And obviously, it cannot be a negative number. So this is always greater than 0. And it can be equal to 0 if wo fully divide ho jaye. Agar wo fully divide ho jata hai, to it can be equal to 0. Therefore, the condition that the remainder is always lies between 0 and B. And it can be equal to 0 as well. So this is the statement which Euclid's division lemma says, and it is used to compute the highest common factor, that is your HCF of two given numbers. Always. The first method we have done in earlier classes is by factorization. Another method is your Euclid's division lemma. So how are we going to do this? Let's take two numbers, 1365 and 125. So the division I have performed, so it can be divided like this by long division method, that 125 by 10 will be 1250 and minus karke it will be 115. And now after this division, your divisor will become your dividend, right? And again you perform the division till the remainder comes out to be 0. Okay. And the step where the remainder is 0, in that step the divisor is called the HCF of the numbers, both the numbers, and always your bigger number will come inside, right? And according to division lemma, if you're going to write it in statement form, it can be written as 1365, that is your dividend, is equal to 125, that is your divisor, into quotient, that is your 10, and your remainder 115. Right, now in the next step, your divisor will become your dividend and your remainder will become your divisor. Similarly, in next step, your divisor is becoming dividend and your remainder is becoming divisor. And again, your divisor is dividend and your remainder is your dividend divisor, and will perform till your remainder comes out to be 0. So in the step where the remainder comes out to be 0, in that step, whatever is a divisor is your HCF, highest common factor of the numbers we have taken before, 1, 3, 6, 5 and 1, 2, 5. So this is all about division lemma, Euclid division lemma. That is just a method to calculate the highest common factor. Some more questions will come and discuss in your next video. So keep watching, keep liking and keep subscribing. Thank you.